Here I have a 200 watt pulsed laser cleaning machine. And here I have a 2000 watt continuous wave laser cleaning machine. Both of these are from Fortune Laser, and today I'll be testing both of these machines to clean the rusty surface of this old table saw. And this old saw sat in a humid basement for about 40 or 50 years. You can see the surface is completely rusted over. Here's a quick look at the parameters I'm using for this project. This 200 watt pulse laser cleaning machine is the FLC200 by Fortune Laser. I'll link a full video all about this machine in the description, as well as a link on Fortune Laser's website. But the biggest advantage of the pulsed laser is that it uses less power and makes less heat while removing rust. So it doesn't alter the original surface of the metal, and that makes it ideal for removing rust, paint, oils, and grease from a variety of applications, including thin sheet metal, aluminum, stone, and concrete, and even wood. Here's a close look, and because there was some very fine pitting in the surface of the metal, the rust was removed, but those pits were preserved. Here's a close-up of the cleaning. Because this machine is using shock waves to break up the surface rust, in addition to preserving the integrity of the original surface, one more advantage of the pulsed laser cleaner is that I end up with a brighter, cleaner surface than I would with the continuous wave machine, which uses raw power and heat to remove rust. Although, on this particular cast iron surface, with the fine pitting caused from decades of moisture, we'll see that the excessive power and heat of the 2000 watt continuous wave laser actually does a better job at leaving a smooth surface, because it doesn't preserve all the details like the pulsed laser does. Let's go into time-lapse mode now, because the main disadvantage of the pulsed laser is its speed. While being far more versatile than the continuous wave, it's also much slower. I did a speed test in a previous video and found that the 2000 watt continuous wave machine cleaned a rusty steel rim about 11 times faster than the pulsed machine. Here's the final result of the 200 watt pulsed machine. The surface is just a little warm to the touch. You can see it didn't come out as clean as I thought it would, all the fine pitting in the cast iron. Let's give the big boy FLC 2000 a turn and see what it can do. Here's a quick look at the settings I'm using. Right away, you'll notice how fast this machine cleans. Also, the darker gray finish it leaves on the cast iron. I think that was paint drops on the surface that was causing the laser to get brighter there. Let's take a close look at the surface. You can see it's definitely not as bright. Some of this was just soot that I can wipe off because the continuous wave machine basically incinerates the rust using excessive power. And looking closer, you can see it's leaving behind etching marks as well. I don't see all the fine pitting like I see up here, but I'm not a fan of those big etching marks. I'm going to bump up the scanning frequency to hopefully eliminate those etching marks. Let's do a wider scan width too. This machine will go up to 300 millimeters. So here's 80 hertz, and over here is 100 hertz. Much better. Some of the worst pitting is still visible, but none of these etching marks left by the 80 hertz. So
So I'm going to do the rest of this at 100 hertz.
I did learn something new here. Once I cleaned the surface with the pulsed laser, I couldn't re-clean that area with the continuous wave laser to achieve the darker, less pitted surface. However, the etching lines left from the continuous wave cleaning at 80 hertz were removed when I went back over with the hertz setting changed to 100. If you have any questions on these machines, let me know in the comments, and as always, thanks for watching.